G'day everyone. 23andMe updated their ancestry composition results recently, but they don't seem to have made a lot of announcements about it, so I thought I'd make a video about the changes. Now, I'm actually going to start with my mother's results, or rather just looking at the little map. And the interesting thing about that is that if you look, they'll show that European basically stretches all the way over to the Kamchatka Peninsula. However, when we go to my results, you will see here that the bulk of the old USSR is now coloured as Siberian. Now, where things start to get interesting is when we go to the few scientific details, because this is where we find that they're actually looking at quite a few more populations and giving you a little bit more information if you know how to dig down than they did. So here we are in the scientific details. And some quite interesting little bit about how they determine your recent ancestor locations, with notes that country borders have changed a lot even within the past 100 years. Now, this is the bit where we're seeing something new. For example, with British and Irish, they've broken the populations down to United Kingdom and Ireland. And as you see with my results, they're giving it a very strong match strength with United Kingdom, and a moderately strong match strength with Ireland, which is sort of the opposite of what Ancestry.com does. So then for French and German, you've got quite a lot of choices there. Austria, Belgium, France, Germany, Luxembourg, Netherlands and Switzerland. Similar story for Scandinavian. Sardinians are standalone. Two options for Italy and Malta. Two options for Iberian, Portugal and Spain, a stack of options for Balkan, stack of options for Eastern European, Ashkenazi Jewish again is still a standalone, and then your Broadleys. Then we go into East Asian and Native American. Again, Siberians are standalone. Korean. Now they've divided Korea into North and South. Interesting. Mongolians had Manchurian added onto it and includes Kazakhstan and Kyrgyzstan as well as Mongolia. Chinese, they've separated out Hong Kong and Taiwan. I'm surprised they haven't included more of the ethnic groups within China itself. Okay, stack of options for Southeast Asia, a lot of options for Native American, but not Canadian and not United States. Then another one that's interesting, because it has changed quite a bit, is they've added in a category called Western Asian. So here you have Armenian, Azerbaijan, Cyprus, Georgia, Iran, Iraq. Interesting that they've included Iraq, Lebanon, Syria, again, those ones I would have thought were Arabic, Turkey and Uzbekistan. However, as I say, they have included them in the West Asian category. Then for the North African and Arabian, you've got Algeria, Bahrain, Egypt, Jordan, Kuwait, Libya, Morocco, Saudi Arabia, Tunisia, United Arab Emirates and Yemen. Now, people have long been waiting for a bit more definition on sub-Saharan African, and here we go. It's perhaps not as great as you might want, but possibly better than nothing. So West African, Cabo Verde, Cameroon, Ghana, Libya and Nigeria. East African, Eritrea, Ethiopia, Kenya, Somalia and Sudan. Southern and Central Africa is now called African Hunter-Gatherer, and obviously you've got your broadly Sub-Saharan African. South Asian, again, you've actually got quite a number of options making up the populations here. Afghanistan, Bangladesh, India, Mauritius. Interesting because it's a bit of a mixed population. Nepal, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka. Melanesian replaces the old Oceanian, but the populations that they've tested to make it up are still the same ones. American Samoa, Fiji, Samoa, and Tonga. And then our old friend, unassigned. There is a wide range of human diversity out there. And sometimes our algorithm can't pinpoint a region of your DNA to a specific population. Bear with us as our data and resources continue to expand. We expect the amount of unassigned ancestry our customers see to decrease. Okay, so that's really, I think, the most important, where the important changes are. So if you are a 23andMe customer, I'd suggest that you take a squiz at your results and those of your close family to see if anything's changed and or to see if you get more information. Thank you for watching.